Tulikuwa na ugeni kutoka nchi ya Romania, kutoka chuo kikuu cha Banat cha sayansi za kilimo na tiba ya mifugo. Ugeni huu ulikuja na viongozi wakuu watatu akiwemo makamu mkuu wa chuo na pia naibu mkuu wa ndaki ya kilimo.
And it's very good here to try to connect with Europe. It's very okay, and we will, I personally and my team invite you to come to our country. We can help you with our project, and maybe with your colleague or professor, maybe come together to our university.
Now we have 45 non-European countries, 84 non-European universities as partners.
Me together with the Vice Rector and my colleague Laura, maybe she can tell you something about the Faculty of Agriculture, because you are a University of Agriculture. We write the project.
Students here from Asia, from Europe, and they study one semester to our university. They choose some same discipline as they have in their own university. And after they receive some marks for their study in our university, they go home and their discipline made are recognized by their university. The exchange is very good, open the students' mind, and after we, even with their professor, we make a very, very good collaboration, a research paper, and even the projects together. So even the climate condition is different in different, but the agriculture is almost the same in all the region. So we try to develop, we try to go together in international projects.
This project Erasmus that we applied last year, it's valid 2 years. So it goes like this every year. This year we added to Sokoine University from Tanzania, we added Dar es Salaam University. Because we met Dr. Pendo in the conference, yeah. And she was willing to apply for Erasmus to be able to exchange stuff from their university. You can add as many universities as you want to a country. I applied for a project of 2,800,000 euros with 46 countries, 84 universities. We were working a long time before coming here. But we met Miriam from Nigeria, and we had to reapply Nigeria. And the same program works with European Union. We have 184 partners in Europe, 184 universities, most of them life science universities. We are in the association called IROICA, International Relations Officer of Life Science Universities.
This initiative basically is going to maybe bring us
closer,
yes, closer and closer. And I'm very thankful for a member of our faculty for having initiated this relationship. And let me assure you that for us, we are here more than ready.
Thank you.
This collaboration.
This is very good to know. And
yes,
you can have partnership with other universities from other areas. Mm-hmm. But for us, it's more interesting to have partners from the same area, not from medicine. Mm-hmm. Yes, you can have,
yeah,
because you have biology, they have biology, chemistry, mm-hmm. But this is agriculture,
yeah.
This is veterinary, this is horticulture, forestry,
yeah.
So we are going on the same track.
The same track. Mm-hmm. And we, I would be even more happy if we can take this relationship beyond the Erasmus program.
When we stayed together during that training, we could see a lot of cooperation and a lot of Yes. The networking was very good, and since then we have continued to collaborate with them. And so, to me, I think Romania, in the past, in this country, we, as a country, used to collaborate with Romania, and I don't know what happened in between here, but again, here we are coming here in our institution here.
Yeah.
It's good that at least our colleagues networked with you and utilized this opportunity. Here we are talking about cooperation.
Ujio wa wageni hawa ni mwendelezo wa ushirikiano, mazungumzo ya ushirikiano ambayo tulianzia Nairobi mwaka jana, ambapo tulikuwa na mkutano wa kimataifa wa wakalimani na wafasiri. Mazungumzo yale tulivyoendelea, wakaona kwamba niko serious, na hivyo tukaingia katika mchakato wa kuweza kuapply kupata ufadhili, kupata ushirikiano kupitia Erasmus, ambayo inafadhiliwa, msingi ni ufadhili wa umoja wa Ulaya, European Union.